Hey, what's up everyone? This week, we are once again going to use Copilot. In a previous video, we've already seen that Copilot was actually quite good at helping us refactor some Swift code. But this time, I want us to take things one step further and see whether or not Copilot is actually able to suggest the implementation of a simple Swift UI app. So let's get started and we'll see just how much Copilot is gonna be able to help me while I implement a simple Swift UI app that displays a to-do list. As you can see right here, when I created my project, I chose to call it To-Do App. And I made that choice on purpose because I thought that naming it that way might actually give a hint to Copilot about what kind of an app I am trying to implement. So let's actually just try to write a new line in the content view and we're going to see what Copilot is going to suggest. And as you can see, it seems Copilot has definitely picked up on what kind of an app I want to implement because here it's suggesting that inside my view, I add an @state property that will contain an array of to-do. So now I'm going to try and implement a struct called to-do just to see what Copilot is going to suggest. So I'm going to start writing the implementation for that struct. And as you can see, Copilot is suggesting that inside a struct, I store two properties, a title, which is a string, and an isDone, which is a bool. So up until now, everything makes sense and Copilot is definitely making some good suggestions. Now let's try to remove the content of the body of my view and let's see what Copilot is going to suggest instead. Okay, so this time the suggestion is much bigger than before, so I'm going to accept it and then we're going to go over it line by line. So first, it seems that Copilot is suggesting that I use a navigation view to embed the content of my content view. And it seems the reason for it is not to actually implement a navigation, but rather to have access to navigation bar items in order to add a button in what is basically the navigation bar of my app. So then inside navigation view, we have a list. Inside this list, we have a for each. This for each is iterating over the to-dos. What's interesting to see here is that you see we are iterating over the array of to-dos, but this code wouldn't build because my struct to-do right here is not actually identifiable. It doesn't conform to the protocol identifiable. So we have a compilation error that we're going to have to fix later, but let's see what is the rest of the suggestion. So for each row of the list, we have an H tag. We have a text that displays the title of the to-do, then a spacer, and then if the to-do has isDone equal to true, we have an image that will show basically a check mark. Then we have the navigation bar title set to to-dos, which makes sense. And finally, we have a navigation bar items. So it's a button that will be placed at the trailing end of the navigation bar. And it's a button. The action is going to append a new to-do to the array and so to the list. And the label of that button is an image that uses SF symbol. And so it's a plus icon. So actually, I want to try and run the app to see how it works. I just need to fix the little issue here. So I'm going to make it conform to identifiable. And then we'll see, yes, it suggests adding an ID. It's good. I'm even going to make it a let, which is even better. Okay, and now I want to see what the app looks like. So up until now, I was in VS Code in order to be able to use Copilot. But to build the app, I'm going to have to switch back to Xcode. And so we are back in Xcode. It's still the same project. It's still the same file. So this time I'm going to try and build the project. And first we'll see whether it builds. So let's go ahead. Okay, the build was actually successful. So without further ado, I'm going to run it in the simulator. Okay, so we have the app running. The list is empty, but that's normal because the array has an initial value of the empty array. And if I click on the plus button right here, it's indeed adding new to-dos to the list. Okay, we can also remark that for now in the app, if I click on the list, nothing is going to happen. So we basically don't have yet a way to set the isDone property to true. So we don't yet have a fully functioning to-do app, but that's already a good start. Now let's go back to VS Code and let's see how Copilot can help us improve on this first draft. Okay, so I'm back in VS Code, and the first thing I want to implement to improve my app is to have a way to basically toggle that is done Boolean property. So I want to have a button that when I click on it, it will make the to-do item go either from false to true or from true to false. So I'm going to implement it right here. So I'm going to get rid of this code. So Copilot is still making the same suggestion, but this time I don't want it. And instead, I want to implement a button that will toggle the Boolean. So first, let me say that I want to implement a button. Okay, so that suggestion is interesting, but it's definitely not what I want. I'm just going to accept it, and then I'm going to remove both these lines of code. I'm going to implement my thing. So let's start with implementing the action of the button. So I'm going to want to something like to do dot is done dot toggle, like that. Actually, I'm not sure whether or not it's going to work. Maybe I'm going to have to turn this to do right here into a binding, but I will see that a little bit later in Xcode. Here, what I want to see is whether or not, now that I have implemented the action, if Copilot is going to be able to make a good suggestion for the label of the button. And it seems Copilot has indeed understood what that button is about, because if we look at the suggestion, so it's suggesting that we test whether or not the to-do is done. If it is done, we display an icon that is a check mark inside a circle. And if it is not done, we just display the circle. So that's exactly what I want. Okay, so let me go back to Xcode to see whether or not the code builds. So indeed, it doesn't work because I need to do to be a binding. Okay, so I've successfully fixed the compilation error by turning to do into a binding. And now I'm going to run the app and we're going to see whether or not this code works as expected. So let's see if I click on the plus icon right here. So we can see the button appearing. And if I click on it, indeed, it seems to toggle the property is done. Now let's see how we can improve even further. What would be nice is that when we add a new to-do, instead of having the title be this hard-coded string new to-do, it would be nice to have a text field to be able to edit that title. So let's go back to VS Code and implement it. So this time I want to take my text right here and turn it into a text field. Let's see what Copilot is going to suggest. So it seems pretty good. It's suggesting a text field with the placeholder title, and the text inside the text field will be bound to the title property of my to-do item. This seems actually pretty good. I'm just going to go back to Xcode in order to run the app to see how it works. So when I click on the plus button, it still creates a new to-do with the title new to-do, because that value is still hardcoded right here. But what has changed is that now that title is inside a text field, and so I can delete the title of my to-do and replace it with something else. Like, for instance, I should remember to post my video on YouTube. Okay, so it's looking pretty good. Let's see what we could implement next. It would be nice to have a way to remove an item from the list. So, you know, some kind of swipe to delete. So let's see if Copilot is able to implement it for us. So we are back in VS Code and we're going to try and implement that swipe to delete. In SwiftUI, when you want to implement swipe to delete inside a list, you do it by calling a modifier on the for each that is inside the list. So I'm going to just try and call a modifier on my for each, and we're going to see if Copilot is going to pick up on that and directly suggest the right modifier to implement a swipe to delete. And as you can see, Copilot has picked up on the fact that I want to implement a swipe to delete. What's interesting here is that it's indeed calling the right modifier, so on delete perform, and it's actually calling a method called delete to do that doesn't exist yet, but I'm going to try and implement it inside my content view, and we're going to see if Copilot is going to be able to suggest the code for that method. So let me go below the body of my view. And as you can see, I didn't even have to write anything. Copilot has immediately suggested an implementation for that method delete to do. So I'm going to accept the suggestion and we're going to go over the code of that method. So first, let's take a look at the signature. So the method is called delete to do just as we expect. And it takes one argument, which is some offsets, which is stored as an index set. And if I remember it correctly, it is indeed the signature that the modifier onDelete expects. And inside, what's happening is that on the array of todos, we are calling remove at offsets, and we just pass in the offsets we receive in the argument. So it seems actually pretty good. So let me go back to Xcode and see if it works. Okay, so the app is running. I'm going to click a few times on the plus icon to create a few to-dos. And then we're going to see what happens when I try to do a swipe to delete. And indeed, seems to work successfully. So once again, Copilot got it right, which is pretty impressive when you think about it. Okay, so what could be the next step for our to-do app? I guess the logical next step would be to implement some kind of data persistence in order to have the content of our to-do list to be saved on disk. So let's go back to VS Code and let's see how Copilot can help us implement this new feature. Okay, so I'm back in VS Code and I'm thinking maybe the best way to give a hint to Copilot about the fact I want to implement data persistence is to make my struct to-do conform to codable like this. And after that, maybe a next step could be to try and implement the modifier onAppear on my navigation view to see if Copilot is going to suggest loading the data from the disk. So I'm going to go at the end of my navigation view, and I'm going to try and implement the modifier onAppear on that navigation view. Okay, so what's interesting is that I didn't even have to write onAppear. Copilot already suggested it. So let's take a look at the code that's inside onAppear. It seems Copilot is choosing to use the user default to persist the data, which makes sense because it's the easiest way to implement data persistence in iOS. So it's storing some data for the key to-dos. And if that data was able to be retrieved, then Copilot is attempting to decode it. And it does so using a JSON decoder to decode an array of to-do. So that code to load data from the disk seems pretty correct. Now what we're missing is the other part, so the code that writes data to the disk. And I'm thinking a good way to implement it in SwiftUI would be by using the modifier that's called, I don't remember the name exactly, but it's something like onChangeOf, I think. And basically you can pass it an atState property, and whenever a property changes, the closure you pass into the modifier will be called. So let's see. Let's see if I try to implement a new modifier, if it suggests implementing the modifier onChangeOf. Okay, so what's interesting here is that it didn't suggest that one. Instead, it chose to use onDisappear, which in a way kind of makes sense. Also, I'm just thinking like maybe if the user like kills the app, maybe onDisappear would not be killed. I'm not sure. I will give it a try actually. So let's take a look at the code inside the modifier onDisappear. So it's basically a mirror version of the code inside onAppear, because we also have a JSON decoder, but this time we use it to encode our array of to-dos. And if that encoding was successful, we store the data inside user default, and we are indeed using the same key to store the data than to retrieve it. So that looks pretty good. Let me go back to Xcode and run the code and see if it works. Okay, so I've built the app and relaunched it. So I'm going to add a couple items to my list. For lack of a better inspiration, I'm just going to call them item one and item two. Okay, like that. And now I'm going to try and force kill my app. This way, we'll see whether or not onDisappear is called when we try to force kill an app. So let me force kill the app. I'm going to relaunch it. And yeah, that's indeed what I was afraid of. When we force kill the app, onDisappear isn't called. And so as you can see, this can lead to data being lost. I still want to test that the data persistence still works when we don't force kill the app. So I'm going to once again add two items. I'm still going to call them item one and item two, because my inspiration hasn't gotten better since the last time. And this time, if I want the view to disappear, like maybe if I just put the app in background, and now if I relaunch the app in Xcode, let's see if we still have the data here when the app reopens. Okay, we also don't have the data, so it seems onDisappear is definitely not the best place to write the code to save the data on disk. So I'm going to actually go back to Xcode and fix this issue. So what I wanted was, instead of using onDisappear, I wanted to use on change off. You know what? Actually, let me get rid of that code. Let me go back to VS Code. And now I'm going to start and implement the modifier on change off. And I want to see whether or not Copilot is going to suggest the same code, but by using that other modifier. So here you can see it's still suggesting we use on disappear, but we don't want to use it. Instead, I want to use on change off. So let's see. Okay, so this seems better. The suggestion seems correct because on change of my array of to-dos, I'm still going to run the same code. So the one that will encode the data and save it in the user defaults. Okay, let me go back to Xcode. Okay, so in Xcode, I have an error because in order for onChange to work, the content of my array must be equitable. So let me go back to my struct to-do. Actually, I also have a warning and it says immutable property will not be decoded because it is declared with initial value which cannot be overwritten. Okay, so if I want my ID to be successfully encoded and decoded, it needs to be a var. So actually, that wasn't such a great idea to turn it into a let constant earlier. And let me do what I went there for. So to make to do confirm to equitable. Okay, let's go back to my view. We see whether or not it builds. Okay, the code builds successfully. So now you know the drill. I'm going to relaunch the app in the simulator. Okay, I'm going to once again add my two to do items. So now you know their names. It's item one and item two. Okay. And this time, actually going to try and force kill the app once again. And we should see the data being persisted. So I'm going to relaunch the app. And that's it. This time, the data has indeed been successfully persisted because the code to write the data on disk is now executed every single time there is a change in the array. So actually, if the list got quite big, this might not be the most performant code because it could easily become a bottleneck. But for our simple app, it's working as expected. And actually, I think I'm going to stop here for this video because the goal I had set has been achieved. We have successfully implemented a simple but fully functional SwiftUI app that manages a to-do list. And what has been quite interesting and quite impressive is the fact that most of the time, Copilot was indeed able to make good and relevant suggestions that helped us implement this simple SwiftUI app and implement it quite fast and quite correctly. But you also might want to bear in mind the fact that there might have been a small bias in the example I took. Because after all, I chose to implement a to-do app, and we all know that a to-do app is one of the most common examples of an app being implemented by people that are discovering a new framework. And so there must be tons of repos on GitHub that implements to-do apps. And since, from what I understand, Copilot has been trained using public repos on GitHub, it's very possible that Copilot is actually better at suggesting how to implement a to-do app than it would be for a different kind of app. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you want to see more content about Copilot, please let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching and see you next time.